All right, welcome to week 15, my friends. Can you believe it? I only have one more lecture to give to you, and it will be next week. And the topic next week, as you can see on the screen, is databases. Really important topic that we will talk about next week. The difference, and do put this in your notes, the difference between CIT 15 and CIT 12, right? You're all taking CIT 12. Is that CIT 15 covers more topics, and it also covers databases and programming. You don't have to put all that in your notes. Just put the differences between CIT 12 and what's the other one?
CIT 15.
Okay? Now, you can go ahead and take 15 at this point. You could have probably already. But for whatever reason, you wanted this class, probably for your major or whatever. But more experience is good. Okay, that's what I would say to you. And so a little programming wouldn't hurt you. And database is one of those things that here's what will happen. Is your employers will love that you have Excel, right? They will somewhat expect you have Excel. But they will absolutely be delighted if you have some database experience. Because every business now has a need to capture data more structured than it is in an Excel spreadsheet. But I have to tell you, what was really cool for me is I just graded your week 14 projects. And what's cool for me is I feel like I'm actually on track with a lot of the comments that I got across the board, is that this class met most of the needs that you had, and you felt like you learned something by the end of it, even if you came in with some knowledge. Many of you did. The only feedback I kind of consistently got was that people didn't like doing the replies. Right? They didn't like the replies to the YouTube research. And I'm like, well, how else would I get you to watch somebody else's? So I'm willing to think about that. Okay? So I'm willing to think about that. So anybody notice my shirt today? Can you see it? I don't know if you can see it. What does it say?
Hack for change.
Okay. How many have heard this term hack? Well, it's hacker. Hacker. Now, is a hacker a good thing? Okay, so let me educate you a little bit. Erica, what'd you say?
Could be.
If you're in the computer realm, those of us that are geeks, when we say hacker, it's actually a compliment. But when you hear hacker because of the media, you think it's a bad thing. In the computer realm, when we talk about people that mean malicious harm, and please, if you want to laugh, that's fine. Guess what term we use? Cracker. And I don't mean us white folks, but it's true. Yeah, I thought that might get a laugh, okay? But, and the reason I'm wearing this shirt is Hack for Change. So there's actually a program nationally. It's called the National Day of Civic Hacking. And we're sponsoring one here in Fresno this year. It's going to be the city of Fresno, the city of Clovis, a lot of other people. And it's where computer people get together and try to do code that actually does good. So I'm a part of that, and I just thought it'd be interesting. But here's what I want to say to you. Hack your grade. Put that in your notes. Hack your grade. Okay? So now let me actually show you what I mean by that. Okay? You guys remember this little Excel thing I had you do that was my grade spreadsheet? You remember that? Well, that's going to come back around in week 17. Okay? Week 17, we're going to revisit this. Sorry. Because what we're going to do is we're going to go from a what your grade is and how it's calculated to what you want your grade to be. But in this process, let's do a little hacking. And hacking really means let's make it work for us. Not in a way that's malicious, but in a way that because you're a little smarter about things, right? So in this scenario, this is kind of where we're at today, and this is nobody's grade in particular. But of the percentage, right, they are currently carrying, if I don't know if you can see this, right, an 88, you see this? 88%, right? 88, it's a little hard to see, but 88 point, okay, by the way, what letter grade is that? Now, do we do pluses and minuses around here?
Yeah.
No. When it hits your transcript, very good, when it's in Blackboard, it will. But when it hits your transcript, no. So I want you to, A, understand that, okay? So in this scenario, really what this is saying is that 83% of our grade is now done. Doesn't mean you can't do late work. You can, all right? But let's actually go down here and let's actually just take, and I'm just going to drag this down, to right before the two items that are right here, which is, let me just pull back just a little bit so we can see it. The two items that I'm talking about is the Send That Final and the Chapter Final, okay? So now, this is a scenario that people will ask. Do I have to take these things? Now, most instructors, when you ask them that question, what do they say?
Yes.
They just say yes. And the answer is, it depends on your grade. And it depends on the percentage that that item holds. Okay? So for every class, you could do something like the My Grade spreadsheet and answer the question for yourself. Do I need to take the final? Okay? Now let's just look at this. So this student right now is sitting at 86%, given that I just auto-loaded the rest. Doesn't matter. So to answer the question, what would you do? Do I have to take either final in this scenario? What would you do? Exactly. You'd come down here, and you'd put zero and zero. So the answer to the question of do I need to take the final is what? It depends on, hold on, it depends on what? Okay, but what was the, let me do this again. Control Z, Control Z. It was 80 what?
86.
86. Okay. Do you need to take the final and keep a B?
No.
No. Now the question would be, let's say I want to go for an A, right? Right? So now how would you do that scenario? Okay, so let's go to the top first, right? Let's say I get 100% on the SimNet and I get 100%, oh, not 199, that'd throw it off. If I get 100% on both of the final items, will I get an A?
No.
Do you now get my hack concept?
Basically to determine whether we should take a final or not.
That's right. And I'm not trying to tell you any instructor is not right, and I'm just telling you for our class that you can answer this question for yourself. Now, in this case, this student, is there other ways they could get to an A?
Yes.
What's the other ways they could still get to an A at their 87%?
Do makeup.
Okay? Now, part of that's going to depend on how much work have you missed. And the max percentage you're going to get is what? For the items that you've missed? 75%. Are you guys and gals all with me at this point?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what do I mean by hack your grade?
Help yourself determine. Work
smarter, not harder.
Help yourself determine whether you need to take the finals.
That's right. Help yourself determine how hard you want to work to get the grade you want to get, because you may be working harder than you have to at the end of this. Now, I'm guessing this happens for you all, is that almost everyone keeps some of the big stuff until the very end. How many of you, a large percentage of your grade is at the end of the class? I'm glad to hear it's not more, because I think that actually sets you up for failure, which is why I pull the grade across the semester. That's why you see my finals and my not having that much of a weight. Okay? All right, questions about this? Any question?
It could also be because of the subject, because that's my biology. Could be the subject.
The subject requires them to have a heavy final?
Yeah.
Could be. Now, by the way, as you go further in education, are you going to see the finals weighing more? Yeah. That is the reality, okay? So it's not that I'm against it. I just want you to know. No questions about that? Okay, next topic. Malware. Put it in your notes. Malware. Boy, is this a topic of interest right now. Okay, how many have heard the term malware? Raise your hands. Okay, what does it mean? You've heard it, but what does it mean? And the picture kind of depicts what it is.
Anything that can infect your computer.
Very good. But actually, we're going to extend it beyond computers, but malware is anything that means you malicious harm. It's malicious. That's what mal means. Ware means software. So malicious software is what this means. And today, my friends, we have a bunch of it, okay? And it comes in various forms. People think it's just viruses, right? I mean, how many of you have been told you need an antivirus, okay? How many of you have been told you need an anti-spyware? Okay, not quite as many. The answer is you do, but I'm going to tell you why. But really, I want you to know all of these things fall under this category. Viruses are not quite as glorified as they used to be, okay? And guess why? Any guesses why viruses? Do you hear about viruses in the news anymore? Not quite as much. You used to hear about them more, right? I don't know if you watched, but the reason that viruses are not the visibility they used to be is that the people who write them realized they could write them and get paid for them, and it's no longer generally called a virus at that point. It's generally called something like crimeware or spyware. So what it is we took all these people that had a really amount of knowledge and we said, I don't mean we like as academia, I mean as a culture, we ended up paying them. People that wanted to do you harm. Again, malware. Now this lecture should scare the bejesus out of you. Okay? If I haven't scared you at all this semester, this is actually kind of my attempt to scare you today. Because you need to be cautious when you're online. I talked about last time being cautious on social media, right? So this is just really your behavior online, okay? So I'm guessing you've not heard of crimeware, right? You've heard of adware?
Yeah.
Yeah? And how about worms?
Yes.
Yeah? So worms really spread through networks. Viruses are really targeted to a desktop. How about Trojans? And I don't mean condoms. You ever heard of a Trojan horse? Do you know where the term came from? Yeah, the Spartan War, where they brought in the horse that it was like a present, but at night, who came out?
Warriors.
In the computer age, here's what this means. You're like, oh, that's a great screensaver. Looks cute. Great images. But guess what it's doing in the background? It's gathering all your personal data and sending it somewhere. So be very cautious before you download stuff. I'll go over this stuff in a little bit. So malware is a huge category that encompasses a lot of